You're in the great outdoors enjoying nature's beauty when all of a sudden you feel a flash of pain. You've been stung. And now your day, or maybe even your life, is ruined.
Creatures that sting are greatly feared, not just by humans, but also by their predators and prey. But just how did stingers come to be? And why do stings hurt so dang much? This is The Evolution of Stingers.
If you've ever known the pain of a sting, you'll know there's nothing quite like it. They're so powerful that we're genetically programmed to be scared of them. Stinging creatures are everywhere, not just flying through the air, but also crawling around on the ground and even lurking underwater. It feels a little safer to be a little further from the ground, which is one of the reasons I got a FlexiSpot standing desk.
This desk also gives my back a rest. Working while standing up makes me feel so much better at the end of the day.
Seriously, guys, the difference is insane. Not only does my back feel better, but I also feel more focused and I have a lot more energy.
And if I feel like sitting down, I can easily adjust it to the height that I want using the presets. Just pick your ideal height and boom, down she goes.
The same process works to make it go up again. And the motors are strong enough to push up all my gear and even me.
See? And even though it moves up and down, the desk is super sturdy. I always have water on hand, which is always a spill risk, especially when my cats Broomy and Sooka jump on the desk.
So whether you're working on your posture or just want to be kinder to your back and neck, or simply just want to be more focused and energetic, you should consider a FlexiSpot standing desk.
I recommend the E7 or the E7 Pro, which is the one I have. But if you're on a limited budget, you could also check out the E5. If your profession requires a high level of stability, or if you need a higher performance desk, try the E7 Plus. And of course, you can get a discount using our promo code 24AUG3.
Click the link in the description and take advantage of their discounts. Your back and brain will thank you for it. This desk is the best desk in the whole wide world. This desk, you better go buy it.
I was skeptical of the accounts I had heard of people being stung thousands of times.
When you think of stings, you probably first think of insects. All stinging insects belong to the venomous Hymenoptera order, which includes bees, wasps, and ants.
Of the stingy insects, there are three that top the Schmidt Sting Pain Index, a scale from 1 to 4 created by entomologist Justin O. Schmidt to categorize, well, the pain of stings. Coming in at number 3 is the warrior wasp.
Native to tropical South America, the warrior wasp sting has been described as being chained to an active volcano. While insects usually try to avoid their stinger and only whip them out as a last resort, the warrior wasp is an aggressive creature that always chooses violence.
While incredibly intense, the pain of the warrior wasp sting only lasts about 2 hours. Stingers evolved in hymenopterans from the female egg-laying organ called the ovipositor. This is why only females of any of these species are capable of stinging. Nowadays, the stinger and the ovipositor are separate organs, except in the case of parasitic wasps, which use their stingers to inject their eggs into their victims.
Which brings us to the second most painful sting among insects, the terrifyingly enormous tarantula hawk wasp. Growing up to 11 centimeters long, these giant wasps use live tarantulas as a horrifying nursery for their little ones. Once paralyzed with its intense venom, the wasp lays an egg on the tarantula and drags the spider to its lair or buries it underground.
Over the next few weeks, the egg will hatch and the wasp larva will devour the still living spider. The bigger the tarantula, the bigger the larva will get. So this wasp sting needs to pack a potent punch to take down the juiciest spider. While Schmidt himself recommends you just lay down and scream after being stung, the pain of the sting luckily only lasts about 5 minutes.
We run far away from the colony sometimes, but they are still behind us. I'm stinging everybody what I see. Child and cows and ducks and ants and chicken and whatever they find.
Most wasps have smooth stingers, which give them the luxury of being able to sting again and again. Honeybees, on the other hand, have barbed stingers, which become lodged in the thick skin of mammals. When the bee pulls out or is brushed away, the stinger stays put and continues to deliver venom for up to a minute after being separated from the rest of the body.
The bee itself is eviscerated and dies within minutes of losing its stinger. This self-sacrifice actually has a function, though, releasing alarm pheromones that warn the hive about the nearby threat.
Topping the list of the most painful stings is the Central and South American bullet ant. Most people associate painful ant encounters with their chomping mandibles.
The bullet ant will chomp down too, but only to hold on tight so it can better stab you with its stinger. This hymenopteran is infamous for being the most painful of all, with its powerful sting making you feel like you've just been shot.
Bullet ants aren't aggressive, but meddle with them and they'll give you the shock of your life. The venom in their sting contains paneratoxin, a neurotoxin that can paralyze and kill other insects and small organisms.
But why would an ant need such a painful sting? It's all part of its intricate defense strategy.
The ants go out and attack caterpillars and things like that that are a good deal larger than they are themselves.
Bullet ants are large and spend a lot of their time scurrying around out in the open, which makes them easy targets.
The sting of a bullet ant is actually the last line of defense, since it has several other strategies that warn away would-be predators. First, they smell like burnt garlic, warning that they're going to taste disgusting. They also make a rhythmic squeak that warns that they're dangerous, kind of like the rattle of a rattlesnake. They're also shiny and black, giving predators a visual warning to stay away.
But if all that simply isn't enough to ward off a hungry predator, that's when the stinger comes out. The venom of a bullet ant evolved to deliver the maximum amount of pain, finally sending any predator foolish enough to tangle with it, running for the hills and full of regrets.
Despite feeling like death is near, a single bullet ant sting can't actually kill a person. 250 stings could, in theory, kill a 150-pound human. Though, so far, there have never been any reported cases of a human being killed by bullet ants, even if their stings will make you want to die.
Most species of ants have the ability to sting and can even cause anaphylactic shock in those who are allergic. Ant sting allergies, however, are far less common than bee and wasp sting allergies. Approximately 5 to 7.5% of people will experience a severe allergic reaction to insect stings in their lifetime. Honorable mention on the Schmidt Sting Pain Index goes to a family of wasps called the velvet ants. While they are velvety looking, this misnomer comes from the fact that the stinging females are actually wingless. Another name they go by is cow killers because of their ultra painful stings. Like the bullet ant, this species has an array of warning tactics meant to keep predators at bay, warning colors, sounds, and chemicals, and finally, if nothing else works, excruciating venom delivered by an unforgiving stinger.
So, which came first, the stinger or the venom? A recent genomic study has shown that the earliest hymenopteran ancestors actually had venom proteins in their bodies before they had stingers. The ability to inject it into a predator or prey evolved later. But it's not just hymenopterans that are capable of stinging. Scorpions, which are distant arachnid cousins of spiders, are also synonymous with stingers.
This scorpion has a poison sac near a stinger in his tail.
Scorpions use their stingers to inject venom that paralyzes their prey. But they will also sting defensively if provoked. The end of their stingers feature tiny holes that inject venom from the bulbous venom glands at the base. The stinger itself is hardened by an accumulation of heavy metals like zinc, iron, and manganese, making it even more reminiscent of a hypodermic needle.
Of the 2,500-ish species of scorpions, about 100 of them produce venom that's powerful enough to kill a human. But creating venom costs the scorpion a lot of energy. That's why over their 400 million years of evolution, scorpions have learned to tailor the amount of venom in their stings to the situation. Sometimes they'll inject a full dose of venom. Other times they'll have a dry sting so as not to waste any. How they differentiate how much venom to use during any given sting is still being studied.
The Deathstalker scorpion, native to the Middle East and North Africa, is known to be one of the most dangerous scorpions on Earth. In the world of scorpions, the bigger they are, the less venomous they actually become. At just 2.5 to 10 centimeters long, this baddie is quite potent indeed. While harmful or even deadly to humans, the venom of the Deathstalker, like the venom of many other organisms, also has the potential to heal.
The chlorotoxin found in the Deathstalker's venom, for example, is currently being investigated to treat brain cancer. Underwater, you'll also find creatures whose stings range from mild to deadly. I'm talking, of course, about jellyfish. And these ethereal beings sting an estimated 150 million people every year.
Unlike the hypodermic needle-style stinger of insects and scorpions, jellyfish have a different mechanism to deliver their venom. Jellyfish tentacles are covered in stinging cells called cnidocytes that contain a stinger. In a millionth of a second, when something brushes against the cnidocyte, the cell opens, letting ocean water in and forcing the barbed stinger and its venom to shoot out like a projectile.
Most of the stings of jellyfish are mild and harmless, but some, like the box jellyfish, contain venom that's extremely lethal to humans. And while the myth persists in pop culture, there's actually no evidence to support that peeing on a jellyfish sting will make it hurt less. Vinegar actually does help, though, in case you want to pack a bottle of balsamic in your beach bag.
Although there are no true stingers among mammals, the males of this species do have venomous spurs on their ankles. I'm talking about the turducken of the animal world, the platypus. Because, of course it does.
Platypus venom is powerful enough to kill small animals and seriously mess with a human, but it's mostly used to paralyze competing males. Whether insect, scorpion, jelly, or platypus, stingers are super effective and massively ouchy adaptations for hunting, defense, and propagation.
It worked, man. Sitting there minding my own business, and here comes that yellow jacket. Boom. Took me down through there, boy. Stung me right on top of my lip. Can't believe it, man. You know what I'm saying? Brung some leftovers from last night, some good old ribs, man, that I prepared from last night. I don't know how I'm gonna eat them junks. Name.
What's the worst sting you've ever had? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new videos every week. Bye.
Tasha, can we get you doing laying down and screaming?
Absolutely.